Stop the presses. Judy Kuvert is ticked off.
I want to express how angry I am that this comes up every 2 years.
Kuvert, who runs PrintCom Inc. in Burien, is talking about I-1185. If it passes, it would renew our current state law, requiring two-thirds of our legislators to agree if they want to roll out a tax hike.
Those who are against this think we're stupid and that we need educating.
Kuvert is upset because after 2 years, a simple majority of the legislature can, and has four times before, suspended initiatives like 1185. When the two-thirds requirement was suspended in 2010, Olympia adopted $800 million in tax hikes, a maneuver Kuvert says could happen all over again.
It's the easy way out. It avoids the hard work of finding ways to reduce spending.
Kuvert says a yes on 1185 would protect her 12-employee company, which is just starting to grow after laying off four people.
We cannot afford any tax increases now. This is too precarious of a recovery.
We're not advocating run out and spend like crazy, but we are advocating provide the legislature with the tools it needs.
The Seattle Metropolitan Chamber of Commerce says President Maude Dodon has come out against 1185.
I think it's going to be really tough to get to a simple majority, let alone beyond that.
Yet the chamber, made up of 2,200 businesses, supported the two-thirds measure, I-1053, back in 2010 as a way to keep a lid on spending. But the chamber did not support I-960, the 2007 two-thirds measure, and stayed neutral when the issue first arose in 1993.
We had definite sentiments on both sides of this issue.
Dodon says this year, the chamber doesn't want a two-thirds majority requirement to jeopardize the support needed for education and transportation projects that are critical for the future of our state's economy.
It's not an objective to grow state government. It's the objective is to grow the foundation upon which lots and lots of small business and big business can thrive.
The objective of the Washington Policy Center puts a different twist on the two-thirds majority debate.
If it's enacted a fifth time, I think that will tell the legislature that making this part of the Constitution is the smart thing to do.
The Policy Center polled a number of state lawmakers last month. 84% said they would vote to allow the public to vote on a state constitution amendment requiring a supermajority to raise taxes.
So we can end the seesaw, the constant back and forth. The people pass it, lawmakers suspend it. People pass it again, lawmakers suspend it again. So let's put an end to the round robin and just put it in the Constitution and put it in place.
Right now, the state Supreme Court is considering if the voter-approved two-thirds requirement is legal to begin with.
The plaintiffs do not meet the legal interest.
The League of Education Voters has filed a suit against Tim Eymann's last identical initiative, 1053. The claim is it's a violation of our state constitution, which says no bill shall become a law without majorities of the House and Senate.
We fought against tyranny of the minority, and that's where our state and our federal constitution comes from. There you go.
State Representative Reuven Carlisle is a staunch enemy of 1185. He says the two-thirds requirement has, ironically, put a minority in power, a small number of senators who can stop any funding measure with a no vote.
17 state senators can block the will of 147 elected representatives, and it simply doesn't work.
And when it comes to funding for the initiative itself, Carlisle notes that the Beer Institute, BP Oil, and ConocoPhillips are the top contributors to the I-1185 campaign.
Those three entities are funding Tim Eymann's initiative in direct retaliation to the legislature's effort to modify and increase some fees in alcohol and in oil to protect Puget Sound and, of course, to provide children's health.
With pressure from lawmakers, big money, and small business, the final edition of the two-thirds voting requirement isn't set to print just yet. But your vote and a decision from the state Supreme Court will be the next headlines.